Welcome the Holy Family. We're glad you're here with us. As we prepare to encounter our Lord Jesus in word and sacrament on the second Sunday of Easter, Divine Mercy Sunday, we pray that our worship may not only bring honor and glory to God, but be a source of special blessing for ourselves, our loved ones, and our whole community. My name is Jeff Turok, and I will serve as lector today. The Mass intention is for William R. Fountain. The presider is Father Bob. As we prepare to pray as one family of faith, let's take a moment now to greet each other, offering your name if they're new to you. Please stand.
Good morning. Please join us for our opening song, Alleluia, 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 which can be found in Breaking Bread, number 175.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Well, good morning and happy Easter. We celebrate Divine Mercy Sunday, the second Sunday of Easter. We welcome you, and particularly we welcome those viewing on our live stream. And my friends, as we begin our celebration this morning, we turn to the baptism font. For my friends, we humbly beseech our Lord to bless the water that he has created, which will be sprinkled on us as a memorial of our baptism. And may he help us by his grace to remain faithful to the Spirit we have received. Lord our God, in your mercy, be present to your people's prayers. And for us who recall the wondrous work of our creation and still greater work of our redemption, graciously bless this water, for you created water to make the fields fruitful and to refresh and cleanse our bodies. You also made water the instrument of your mercy, for through water you freed your people from slavery and quenched their thirst in the desert. Through water the prophets proclaimed the new covenant you were to enter upon with the human race. And last of all, through water, which Christ made holy in the Jordan, you have renewed our corrupted nature in the bath of regeneration. Therefore, may this water be for us a memorial of baptism we have received, and grant that we may share in the gladness of our brothers and sisters who at Easter have received their baptism. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Born on the earth, we are poured from the darkness and clothed in the
May Almighty God cleanse us of our sins, and through the celebration of this Eucharist, make us worthy to share at the table of his kingdom. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast kindle the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was of one heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possessions was his own, but they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them and bring the proceeds of the sale and put them at the feet of the apostles, and they were distributed to each according to need. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting.
Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Aaron say, his mercy endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, his mercy endures forever. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting.
I was hard-pressed and was falling, but the Lord helped me. My strength and my courage is the Lord, and he has been my Savior. The joyful shout of victory in the tents of
give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is
a reading from the letter of St. John. Beloved, everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God, and everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by him. In this way, we know that we love the children of God when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, that we keep his commandments. And his commandments are not burdensome, for whoever is begotten by God conquers the world, and the victory that conquers the world is our faith. Who indeed is the victor over the world but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came through water and blood, Jesus Christ, not by water alone, but by water and blood. The Spirit is the one that testifies, and the Spirit is truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.
with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book, but these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I'd like to share with you a letter written by a man to his friend named Donatus. This letter was written back in the 3rd century. And this is what he said. "It is a bad world, Donatus. An incredibly bad world, but I have discovered in the midst of it a quiet and good people who have learned the great secret of life. They have found a joy and wisdom which is 1,000 times better than any of the pleasures of sinful life. They are despised and persecuted, but they care not. They are masters of their souls. They have overcome the world. These people, Donatus, are Christians, and I am one of them." That letter, written in the 3rd century, in what we know now to be Saint Cyprian, who wrote that letter to Donatus, sounds a lot like what we heard in the first reading today from the Acts of the Apostles. The way of life that they lived was far different than the world they lived in. Acts says today that the community of believers was of one heart and mind. They looked out not for their own needs, but the needs of those who were needy around them. And they sacrificed for them. We hear in the first letter of St. John in the 2nd reading that whoever is begotten by God conquers the world. And the victory that conquers the world is our faith. Who indeed is the victor over the world? But the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God. And we celebrate in this Easter season Jesus, the Son of God, who came to destroy sin and death and has risen from the dead. And his resurrection and new life is ours. We have a new way of looking at life. because we are one in Christ. We who have been baptized and renew that divine life at Eucharist. And the question that rises from the scriptures today invites us to ask ourselves, what do these experiences of the early church, how does that compare with your experience in faith and in your membership in the Catholic Church? What difference does your faith in the risen Jesus make for you? Jesus speaks of us as blessed in the gospel reading today. We who have been blessed have not seen and have believed. St. Luke reminds us that we who believe, we who are followers of Jesus, when much has been given, much will be required. And more will be asked of one to whom more has been entrusted. And what is the treasure that we have been entrusted with? Our faith in Jesus. Our faith in a God who has overcome the world and its sin and evil. A question maybe we ask ourselves is, how much have we blended into the world and have not stood out as followers of Jesus, who reflect what we heard in that reading from the third century author St. Cyprian, or in the Acts of the Apostles, in the way of life they lived so far differently than the people around them. We pray on this Divine Mercy Sunday for the grace of God's mercy, for the help that we need to strengthen the faith in the risen Jesus. The faith that we have and celebrate here today at Eucharist, we pray that this faith in the Lord and the Eucharist, that power he offers us, may help us to really make a profound difference in the way we live our lives, and in turn the lives of those we encounter each day who are longing for the touch, the mercy, the goodness of God. May our minds and hearts be one, just as we heard in the Acts of the Apostles. The community was of one mind and one heart. May we be of one mind and one heart with the mind and heart of Jesus as we encounter him and receive him anew at Holy Eucharist. Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, and who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Jesus is alive, and now we come with trust in his mercy and offer these prayers.
For the church, that each of us who have received the Holy Spirit may continue the mission of spreading God's love, mercy, and forgiveness that Christ has entrusted to us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace, that God will bring an end to the wars and violence occurring in many corners of the world, protect the people affected, and help them to heal and rebuild their lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who struggle with faith or live in fear, that God may liberate their hearts and minds and open them to a fuller life in a personal relationship with Jesus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a renewed appreciation for the sacrament of reconciliation, that God will help us recognize the healing power and peace that one can experience by making a good confession, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, that Jesus, who is the resurrection and the life, may welcome them into the kingdom of heaven, especially at this Mass for William R. Fountain. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the petitions received on our parish prayer line and for the personal needs and intentions we offer in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. O Lord our God, bless us and grant these petitions we offer through Jesus Christ our Lord.
The disciples.
pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the love of his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people and of those you have brought to new birth, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For in the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When he eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of his saving passion, his wondrous resurrection, and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Sean, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. 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 At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Of peace, wherever forgive when there is entreat on. Make me an instrument of your peace. Make me an instrument of your
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts through Christ our Lord. We invite you to celebrate Divine Mercy Sunday today, this afternoon from 3 to 4 p.m. here in the church. And it's not too late to do the 14-day email prayer challenge, which begins tomorrow. The last chance to sign up is today. Small groups and adult Bible study are beginning soon. Please check the bulletin or our website for details. Bridge families are invited to pick up a bridge bag for the month of April in the front narthex after Mass. And if you missed the clergy health and retirement collection last weekend, you can still make a donation by using one of the envelopes found at the doors of the church or give online at the website found in the bulletin. And please pray for the repose of the soul of Mary Wilson, whose funeral Mass will take place here on Saturday at 10 a.m. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Jesus Christ is risen today. Alleluia. Our triumphant holy day. Alleluia. Who did once upon the cross, alleluia, suffer to redeem our loss, alleluia. Hymns of praise then let us sing, Christ our heavenly King, alleluia. Who endured the cross and grave, alleluia. Sinners to redeem.